Hey guys, it's your girl Ian, and you're watching Sunkissed Somewhere. If you're new to my channel, welcome. If you're an old subscriber, welcome back. My name is Ian Bernos, and I do videos on travel, lifestyle, and confidence 3 times a week, every single week, or when I can. For today's video, I'm going to be talking about my March 2019 favorites. So just sitting down to chat with you guys about the things that have been making me happy this last month. Again, as always, don't forget to subscribe down below, click that notification bell so you can get updated whenever I post a video. Also, connect with me on Instagram or follow my blog, it's sunkissedsomewhere.com. Whew, shall we begin? We shall. Okay, so number one on my list is a YouTuber called Amy Landino. I have been watching her for the past month. I discovered her while I was walking on the treadmill, and I was just looking for more productivity channels that I could follow, and I just absolutely loved her energy and how she talked to the camera like a boss, you know what I mean? She just commanded the vlog so well, and she was so articulate, and she knew what she was talking about, and you knew that whatever advice that she was giving, she was actually living it, because she looked so put together. So I love people who inspire me and motivate me and are just good role models altogether. So yeah, I like her no-nonsense style to getting shit done. So there we go. Okay, next one on my list of favorites is a book that I'm currently reading. I'm actually almost done with it, but it's called Into Thin Air by John Krakauer. This is his personal account of the Mount Everest disaster in 1996. It's like 2 years after I was born. I watched the movie, I think it was in 2013 when it first came out. You know, it terrified the shit out of me because it was a real life disaster and it was a horrifying event in history. But at the same time, it really intrigued me because Everest just seems like an elusive goal for anyone who likes to climb mountains or who just enjoys the outdoors. You know, when you think of Mount Everest, it's like the pinnacle of human strength or human willpower even. It's not just strength, it's willpower, it's all sorts of factors. Now I'm learning, actually. This book is really thought-provoking, especially if you're someone who enjoys the outdoors, especially climbing mountains or hiking. To see the passion of these people to actually go through that much to just to summit Mount Everest, it's humbling, it's terrifying, I have no words at the moment, really. It's just really interesting to see how their thought process is, especially at that high of an altitude. I would never do that. I mean, the cold itself is killing me, and I live in Spain, it's not even London, or it's not even somewhere much colder. So yeah, it's something I would never do, but I like reading about it anyway because it's just wow. What I really enjoy about this book is that I'm learning a lot of vocabulary words, because with this e-reader I can just select any word and then it will show me its definition, part of speech, etc. So okay, my favorite playlist on Spotify is called Lo-Fi Beats. I saw a meme about how like some students are using lo-fi beats too much because, you know, to study and stuff, and I've literally been listening to that playlist every day, and it just relaxes me and it gives me this like extra oomph when I'm walking down the street. You know, life is much more cinematic with beats like that. Okay, podcasts. Let's talk about podcasts. I'm currently enjoying Matt Diavolos. Do you know him? He's a YouTuber. He's amazing. So I don't need to introduce him, I think. But okay, so he has a podcast called The Ground Up Show, and his podcast is a really, really interesting way to get to know more amazing, successful self-starters who are, you know, making their mark in their respective industries. So recently I listened to this episode with Jerry Chu. He and Matt talked about how he started in the advertising industry, and I just really enjoyed Matt's way of asking questions because he really gets deep into the topic, and it's something that as a listener I would 100% want to know as well. So it's really good. If you want to learn more things about getting started, motivation, success stories, definitely head to that podcast and listen to it right now. Now, after you finish this video, of course. Okay, going back to hiking, I did 3 hikes this week. I did 3 hikes this month and absolutely enjoyed it. The first hike that I went to was the Lonely Mountain with Sonia and Katie and Hannah. We all went together and it was really good, but also it was the toughest mountain that we did this month. The second one, I went by myself and I met a bunch of people, so it was also very cool. The third one, it was this beautiful canyon. I went with Janica and Billy, and then we met a couple of friends there. It was really nice. I don't think I've ever seen landform like that before. So definitely something different, especially from what I'm used to in the Philippines, you know, all that Philippine hiking, I definitely miss them, but it's also interesting to see different types of hills and mountains. Okay. Lastly, I want to talk about my writer's gym. It is a meetup group that I go to every Wednesdays, and I think I've mentioned this in another video, but just to give you a better look at how it works. I met this group on Meetup, and every Wednesdays we meet up at a local coffee shop and we write short stories based on a prompt. So for example, do you want me to read a short story that I did? Okay, let's do it. So basically the whole idea is to start writing with less editing. So we are given 30 minutes each to write a story based on a prompt. Now the prompt is selected by the group, whatever it is for the week. We have a generator and we just follow it. And whether it's good or bad, we try to read it out loud and get feedback from the other members of the group. So now I'm going to read a short story that I wrote last week, and hopefully, honestly, this is one of my weaknesses. Fiction writing is one of my weaknesses, but I feel like it's something that I really need to get better at, so I'm gonna share it with you guys anyway. Okay, so the prompt for this one is, she tipped the contents of her handbag. So we need to create a story based on that. Like, we could start with it, or we could put it at the end, or we could put it in the middle, it doesn't matter, but that is the prompt. And whatever inspires us, we have to write it. So, this is what I wrote. She tipped the contents of her handbag on the bathroom floor. The same handbag that's accompanied her day and night for the last 8 months. It was a spacious black leather satchel that carried piles of grad school paperwork by day and a makeshift overnight bag for rendezvous with dashing bachelors who, in the morning, would reveal themselves to be mediocre man-children who have an affinity for questionable life choices. A few weeks ago, it was a law student named Mark who had a pizza tattooed on his bum, but that's a story for another day. Tonight, Jess had brought her ever-reliable satchel to a small hole-in-the-wall jazz club she's only heard of 2 hours ago when she overheard her new expat friend, Josie, planning a visit with her new local boyfriend. Jess had never met him, and she wasn't quite keen to. Josie's presence was more than enough to deal with, after all. Josie is everything she isn't, what with her crimson lipstick, impeccable, messy on purpose dark blonde hair, and wardrobe that seemed to only include black turtlenecks and white button downs. Josie had class. Jess had that lonely satchel. She rummaged through it and found the usual suspects. 2-year-old makeup, crumpled foil packets tucked into one of the inner pockets, candy from the last Uber she took, crumbs from the Taco Bell takeout, and receipts from her morning latte trips that shouldn't even exist. Where on earth was that 5-euro bill she'd been saving? So again, it's not a complete piece, it's not a complete short story, it was just the beginning of something, but the whole idea is you have 30 minutes to just create something, write something without editing, and read it out loud. So yeah, this is what I do on Wednesdays. It's really fun and I truly enjoy it. Actually, it's a Tuesday now, and tomorrow I am going back to writer's gym, hopefully getting better. Anyway. Okay, so those are my favorites for the month of March. If you have any other recommendations, suggestions for me, leave them in the comments below and I'll gladly read through them. Hopefully they make it to the next one because I love exploring all these new things, especially book recommendations. If you have any, please comment down below. Anyway, so I hope you guys enjoyed this video and I hope I see you soon. Don't forget to stay confident. No, no, no.